Welcome to self scripting tutorial. Before attending this tutorial, you should have knowledge about Linux commands. For that, you can watch my Linux basic tutorial. Link is mentioned in the description. First part of the session, we'll discuss about difference between C programming and shell programming. We are doing this comparison because most of the people have C programming basic knowledge, and this comparison helps for easy understanding of shell programming. First of all, what is a shell? Shell is a tool to execute user commands. Shell is a program that acts as an interface between user and operating system, allowing user to enter commands for the Linux operating system. Shell scripting can be like a programming language. A sequence of commands can be automated to execute one after the other in a shell program. For example, we have to run a set of 10 commands on a daily basis. In manual execution, we need to enter the first command and wait for it to complete to execute the second command. This process is time-taking. Instead of this, we can write a shell program to execute these 10 commands one after the other. Those commands will execute without the user having to wait. We can also see the output of each command. In case any command failed, we can also see the details also.
For example, in the C programming language, so you know that the extension of the program is a .c. For example, hello. So here the extension is a .sh, hello.sh. So in the C programming language, we are using like a comments, okay? So that double hash is a single line commented. You want multiple lines commented, slash star, okay, and star hash. So it's a comment in the C programming language. But shell programming language, comment is a hash. Every line you want commented hash one. As begin is a comment line, okay? So in the C programming language, if you need a compiler, definitely need a compiler, because .c file is a high level programming language. So definitely we need to convert the binary file. With the help of the compiler, okay, linker, you generate the binary file. The default binary file is called a.out. The C programming language write a .c file, with compiler generate the binary file, execute the binary file, you can see the result. That every day we are doing like that. So but in the shell programming is what? Hello.sh. Generally when you write the hello.sh file, this file is a normal text file only, by default, text. But extension .sh only, but the behavior is a normal text file. But default text file contain the read or write permissions only. So the text file doesn't have the executable permissions. That's why you provide the executable permissions only. How you provide the permission? I told you chmod, change mode command. Okay, a plus x, executable permission given, hello.sh given. So whenever you want to run this command, hello.sh file contain the executable permission, nothing but binary permissions are coming. Once binary permissions coming, you can now execute now. Yeah. Dot class, okay. No dot. Hello dot. Now can see the result. Now can see the result. So in the shell programming, write a shell program, only first beginning time only provide the executable permission. Okay, X is executable permission. So once permissions are given, execute and see the result. Here there is no compiler. Okay, so the C programming language need a translator, because high level programming different, binary different. With the help of translator, the compiler translate the language. So now we can execute. But here there is no translator. We are just to write the program. The program contain the binary file. There's like a command, ls command with a binary, copy command. What are the commands you mention? Okay, they are all binary one now. Just you can give the skip to the binary file, you can execute and see the result. Okay, so what about the development cycle of the C programming language? The dynamic development cycle, for example, you want to modify the .c file, again, compiler is required, generate the binary file, execute. The modification of the program, generate the binary file, execute, see the result. Lengthy steps actually. The development cycle. The development cycle is very simple. Modify the scripting language, execute. That's all. Only one time only permission given. So developing always very simple. The C programming language, everybody generally, your printf is a called a, you know, the monitor, print into the monitor output. Okay, printer. Here no printer. In the cell program, C program, there no printer. But the other alternative here is echo command. Here echo like a printer like that one. Echo command. C programming language data types are mandatory. Okay. Figure, character, float, whatever. So the programmer, if you are going to declare some local variable, global variable, whatever, we are going to store some data. The data is a programmer. You can, depending on the requirement, we can allocate the data, array, strings. Okay. The way is a, data types compulsory here. Support, okay. But in the cell programming, there is no data types actually. So like here there's no integer character like that. Okay. Here can variables are there. So the integer variable does separate, character variable separate. Because integer variable is for integer data, one can understand. But here there's no data type, but here variables are there. So here the variable, it can store anything. You can store strings also, integer also, float also, any kind of information you can, decimal, anything it can store. C programming variable declaration, initialization is mandatory. The local variable, global variable, the scope of the variable, but the general story, okay? But here, no, that not required. Your variable declaration is not required. Wherever you want to, the variable you can use. But no need like a starting program, declare the variable, not like that. Any moment you can able to use the variable, any position, any time, okay? There are no particular rules here or no. So that is the reason cell programming is a very easiest programming language. Here header files are not required here, okay? But here there are no requirement like that actually, because your functions are there, but there are no function declaration. Okay, your variables are there, there are no variable declaration. Okay, but you can send the variable global also possible. That we are going to see with some commands, you can know that the variable scope is coming to one file to another file also possible, like extend keyword here like that in the C programming. The concept is possible, but yeah, other files are not required. Okay, but in the C programming language, main function compulsory. Main. Without the main function, there no C programming. Okay, because the main is a program beginning or ending, the main function decide. The program execution time, the binary call execution time, main is a function invoking, starting by default, main function invoking. So main is a beginning ending only. But in the cell programming, there is no main function. The starting line, whatever line, the line executed. After the line executed successfully, then second line executed. Like line by line, the interpreter execute the line by line until end of the program. Okay, so that's the basic difference. Huh? We can see, I'm writing some C programming, like a hello.c, C programming. So in the hello.c, generally, first we write the, stdio.h, because it's a standard input-output, here printf declaration is there, okay? That's why the header file mentioned, okay? And the main function, because the C programming main compulsory, the C programming language, okay? In the int, main return value is an integer. So it is a mandated to mention, actually, because so the your program success or failure, the return value decide actually. Whenever your program success, nothing but main function success, return value 0. In your program fail, return is some integer number, okay, some number indicating, okay. That is the reason the return value compulsory, okay, main. And last line you can return. Your program success, last line, return value 0, ending on 0. 0 indicates success of the program. So and we are only hello world program, that's what printf, the library. Yeah, hello world, we are printing now. Yeah, that's all. This is C programming. Okay, very simple. But this is C programming, you can see ls space hyphen l hello.c. You see the permissions now. The C programming, you can see that the read and write permission, because it's a text file, your normal text file only. Okay, you can see file format also. The file format is a text file actually. Okay, ASCII text file only. It's a C source one, text file. So this file, there no executable permission. There no executable permission. Now this file, now we can't execute because it's a high level programming language. So we need a compiler, and generally in the Linux with the GCC compiler, and hello.c, the program is the input of the compiler, and generate output hyphen o is a user defined output. In case hyphen o is not mentioned, default output is a dot out. Okay, a dot output generated, default output. Now run the, now can check the a dot out output, is a, can check it, is a binary file, you can see, is called a, you can see, even also, you can see, is you can call executable linkable format, is a binary file format, is a binary file, a dot out now. So GNUC compiler input, the input of the compiler is a source file. So whenever this command executed successfully, output generated is a binary. The default binary is called a .out. It's an executable linkable format. Which architecture support? Intel 64-bit architecture support. Now run the binary file, how to run? .lat a.out run. Now you can see the result is what I mean, hello world is coming. The C programming story. In case if you want to modify the C programming, then how to modify the programming? Using VM editor, again modify the hello.c file. Okay. So in case I can add one more printf line, for example, I can add one more line. Okay. First line hello world, next line is it. In case kernel master, I can add one more line. So save the program. Okay. So compulsory, again, compilation mandatory, because once you are modify the program, again, regenerate the binary file also mandatory. So again, with the compiler, generate the binary. Okay. Again, execute the result. Okay. Now you can see the result is coming like that. Okay. So in the C programming, the language, you can see where general programming. So write the programming, compile every time. Whenever you modify the program, the result you want to ship, definitely compiler required. But this type of thing is not required the shell scripting, because the shell is like an interpreter, okay? It doesn't require actual shell program. Okay, so now in the shell scripting program, you write a shell program like a hello dot sh, your extension is dot sh now, extension. Okay, so now in the shell programming extension, shell program starting line is a hash exclamation mark, slash bin sh now is starting line. So I told already in the shell programming hash represent as a comment. Okay, after hash whatever you mentioned, okay, is a comment line actually. It is just comment line. Hello world, the script, program. Okay, I think here people know also the C programming, the comment line. Okay. The C programming comment is another can see another. Can see another. Hello world. Okay. Another, yeah. Okay. That's the comment. Okay. But your comment is hash is comment. Okay. But you can see here, people observe here, hash exclamation mark. So hash followed by exclamation mark without the space. There's no space. Okay. See, no. That is some indication. Okay. Now that is like a beginning of the cell. The cell program is starting indication. So the meaning of hash exclamation mark, which type of cell you are going to use, because maybe in your system multiple cells are installed, like a C cell, bash, TC cell, and number of cells may be there. Okay. So now that this indicate like your entire cell programming run by which one? SH run also, your whole system run. So because SH is cell, the cell is a program, a tool, where located bin folder is also a program. Okay. So the bin folders contain actual bin. The top root bin is what binary. So cell is a tool, it is a binary, okay, the program to execute your command. Okay, that's a starting line. Okay, so that's the SH point of the bash cell, C cell, T cell, whatever in your system, whatever installed, but by default is a bash only. But you have responsibility in the cell programming compulsor every time write down this line actually. Okay, because this line indicates this cell you are going to execute. Okay, the line important. Okay, the type of the cell, because multiple cells in your system. Okay, line. So your printer, your demo printer, but I told alternative user is echo is there. Echo is a printer like that. Echo. Okay, now echo hello world. Hello world. So and one more thing, echo by default support the new line operation. By default support only. Echo hello world, and new line automatically coming. If you want avoid the new line, hyphen n option is given. It avoids the new line. Okay, so hyphen n is removed. By default, new line is coming. So that's all. The hello world cell programming. Yet there is no main function in the cell programming. There is no main function. Okay, in the C programming, main is compulsory. Okay, yet there is no main function. Starting line only are executed. Whatever starting line, what starting line tell me is a comment line. It doesn't run. Second line is the line executing also. Echo is what command. So in the cell program, you mention the commands only. First command, second command, all the commands you mention. Command by command, it execute. That's why called interpreter, is not a compiler. Okay. The first command execute, you show the result. Then second command execute, you can show the result like that. Okay. Now save this file. Okay. Save this file now. So now this file, there no, can see no, this file, whenever you write the file, the file, there are no executable permission. Okay, that's why we have responsibility to provide a executable permission. How to provide it? A plus X, like that one. Okay, now see. So anything but all, what all user, group, others, plus permissions are given. Which permission? X executable permission. Now you can run the commands, you know. See. Abdullah, the previous color is a white color, now color is a green color actually. So the green color indicate that is a binary file, executable permissions now. Now you can see X coming, you know. Your people observe also clearly. Here X coming, X. Your X, you know, you see X, yeah. Earlier you can see X is not there. Earlier X is not there. Okay. User have X permission, group have X permission, others have X permission. Everybody have execute this binary. Yeah, like a binary now, execute now. Just run only, run. There's no compiler, just run it now. How to run? Dot slash hello dot. Just run and see the result. Hello run. Okay. In case if you want modify the cell programming, modify using editor, you can modify the cell programming. You are going to add one more line. Okay, you can add one more line. Okay, like you know, just to, you know, copy the first line, paste it, second line you can modify. Yeah, modify the second line and save the file and save the file and run the binary file. Okay, and you can see the result. Yeah, hello world, if kernel master is coming. Okay, but what happened then? You have no compiler. Okay, so once you modify the cell, just run and see the result. That's all. Okay, nothing, there no compiler, no. But execution time, any syntax errors are there. Maybe you have some syntax, no, the cell have some syntax will be there. There are the syntax will not follow, it throw error. Execution time only. So, but in a C programming language, compilation time, check the syntax actually. Compilation time, print of what the syntax, okay? The syntax follow, compilation time. Because once binary file generated, definitely the chances are there to execute the binary file. But here is not like that, okay? Execution time only can check the syntax now. If you are not following the syntax rules, okay? Like that. So, and one more difference, you know, in the between the C programming and shell, okay? You know, maybe, you know, other programming language comparison, generally. So, other differences, you know, also, you know, for example, you have the scanf is there, okay? The scanf, okay? For example, the scanf, you know, scanf is a basically very important, you know, the one, the, like an input, like a read from the keyboard, okay, scanf. From user, you can take the data, the scanf. It also some format specifier, the data types are follow, read it now, in the C programming language. But cell programming, here the scanf, we also read from the keyboard. The cell programming also needs some input from the user, the keyboard. That's why here one command is there, that is a read command, read. Read command, okay. Yeah, read nothing but like a scanner like that. Echo nothing but like a printer like that. Okay, commands only. Echo is a command, read is a command, okay, read, and I think you mentioned variable name also. I think we are entering the data, where you can store some variable. The variable name you mentioned. Okay. But here is a syntax, you know, scanner, different, you have the variable address you mentioned, address of variable you mentioned here. Scanner also compulsory. So because that data type we are enter, whatever, integer enter, decimal enter, whatever. So the same thing, yeah. Just variable, read space, variable. They're not very big syntax, very simple. For example, read space ABC. That's all. ABC is variable. Okay, so whatever data you enter, the data, you have no data types, you can enter integer, string, whatever, float, whatever enter, you go to ABC. Enter. So the enter indicate the end of the character, you can store the ABC variable. Okay, it's very easy, I think compare maybe you can people see very simple for example, so you can see the cell programming, yeah. So in the read, okay, for example, see read ABC is some variable, the variable actually read ABC. So whatever you enter, the data go to ABC, that's all, enter. But how to print the value, how to print the value of the variable, okay? For example, echo is a printer, but the variable value are going to printing, okay? So you can see, I'm going to printing a, you can see, ABC is a variable name, the value of the variable I'm printing. So the before the variable name mention dollar, then the value of the variable is automatically printed, okay? So echo, what echo tells the printer, ABC colon. So what is dollar number? The value of the variable, ABC is a variable, okay, the content of the variable printing, okay, what are the user enter, because we can see the variable. But when people observe, here there is no variable declaration. Okay, directly can use the variable or no. But in the C programming, in the scanf, you mentioned C programming, you know, everyone knows. So if you want a scanf, definitely you have, first of all, variable declaration compulsory. You know, the scanf, variable declaration compulsory. Okay, definitely. For example, you want integer variable, integer, something, variable, ABC is a variable, you have taken variable, ABC variable. Definitely, so the variable we are going to, whatever the variable you mentioned, okay? The address you mentioned, actually, address of the variable you mentioned, okay? That is address of, okay, ABC you mentioned, okay? So the variable compulsory mention, okay? So now, what are the variable you type now? You can store the value here, okay? The variable value you can store, okay? It's compulsory. So the type of the variable indication here. So your variable declaration mandatory. Okay, now here nothing directly can use the scanf, read scanf, the variable name directly can use it. Okay, so once read, read is what scanf, waiting for some data from the keyboard, the waiting. Okay, for example, I mentioned I'm telling user some indication, something indication, enter data, enter some data, enter input variable, enter. So, okay, whatever the data I enter, okay, integer, character, nothing, whatever you can enter here. So, but in the C program, you have data compulsory, here, whatever data you can enter. So, the data where you can store ABC variable. So, the variable, how you can print? So, the variable before you can mention dollar, the print the value of the variable. Okay, so now you can see the very easy to run. So, you can see now, what is the program? See, there's no compiler, no run should, you have no interpret. Write the program and execute. So, what first line? Hello world. What second line tell me? Enter data. What second line? Enter data. Now is that what third line? Read. Read is a what? Waiting for some data. Like a scan action. Waiting from some user data. The waiting. Okay. The scan action. Okay. Now user now enter some data. Some data can user try to enter. Whatever data you can enter. Maybe I mentioned for example, I enter kernel data. The string I enter now. Okay. Once if you enter key. So nothing but the data scale to the ABC variable. Next line, what will me? The value of the ABC variable we are printing now. You can see now. Yeah, whenever I enter the key, so they can see the ABC colon, dollar ABC. That is the dollar ABC, content of the ABC variable is a kernel. Printing now. So like that, you can enter not only for string, you can enter either integer variable, okay, is also coming. You can enter some float variable, is also coming. So like that, there are no data type actually. You can store whatever you want. That's why cell programming is a very, very easy programming language. Okay, it's a very simple and very easy. Compared to no data type, nothing, no variable declaration, and simple difference between the cell and the C programming.